Hi, this is Tracy HD, and I want to thank you for joining me today for another daily energy and guidance reading. And today is February 21st, 2020. However, I consider this timeless. Whenever the message reaches you is when you're meant to hear it. We're using the Work Your Light Oracle cards by Rebecca Candle. Candle. Listen to me, I'm tongue-tied already. By Rebecca Campbell. And these are absolutely beautiful, beautiful cards. The energy and the artwork is so peaceful. And you can use this as a pick a card reading, card 1, 2, or 3, or you could use it as a combined reading with all three cards for your message. It's up to you. As I shuffle the deck, I'm asking all light beings, angels, and God, please relay the message I need to share with my viewers for the highest good of all. Okay, we'll take the top card for card number 1. Take a card from the center for card number 2. And we'll take the bottom card for the third card. Okay, and let's see what we have here. Oops. Okay, card number 1 is protection. How beautiful. And it says, call back your power, cut the cords, soul retrieval. And this is an amazing, amazing card. And protection is very important. Protection to me is making sure that maybe I have a piece of black tourmaline or some type of protective stone, either that I'm wearing one or maybe carrying one in my purse or pocket. Or I love black obsidian. Also, cutting the cords, I feel from spirit is removing those people that you've been so attached to in a negative, toxic way. And I know sometimes it's hard to remove, you know, friends, families, members, relationships, partners, spouses, lovers, anyone that you have a connection to that is not for your highest good, that's not allowing you to grow, that's holding you back. I think of cutting the cord with someone like that. And what this card is saying is you are being called to protect your energy and call back your power. May all the lost pieces return home now. Take a look at who and what drained your energy. Do not keep your tabs open. Shut down energetically each night. Energetic cards are formed between people, places, objects, and events, so it's important to keep checking in. Your energy and energetic space are sacred, so treat them as such. Keeping your energy clear takes work. As we go through life, we can give away our power, so it's important that we call it back by cutting energetic cords or doing a form of healing known as soul retrieval. Can you think of a traumatic event, relationship, or soul memory that you're being called to call back your power from? Check into your body now and see which chakra feels like it needs a bit of energetic cleanup. Yes, there's a lot of really beautiful videos here on YouTube about cord cutting. And I keep mentioning this because it had been such a traumatic experience I had this summer that I did have to cut a cord with a family member and another person. Since I've done that and since I've distanced myself, I've felt a tremendous amount of stress leave my body. I suffer from lower back sciatica and it had been off and on for a few years. And as soon as I cut the cord with these two people, I haven't had a backache since last June. Emotionally, yes, I'm still drained. But physically, I realized a lot of the symptoms that I was experiencing that were causing me distress have ceased to exist anymore because I've removed myself from the energy of these people. So someone out there needs to cut the cord. And you'll know how you feel when you're around certain people. I mean, are you feeling exhausted and drained when they walk into the room? When the phone rings and you know it's them, is it like your heart sinks? You know, those are not good things. So you need to do some cord cutting this weekend. And taking your power back, no one has the right to control you. It's up to you to take your power back from these people. And sometimes it's as simple as going no contact. To me, that is the best way because I'm not the kind to argue. Most of the time, people know what they've done wrong and they'll just defend themselves until you're blue in the face. So, okay, moving on to the next card. We have a repeat card. We had this card earlier this week. I believe it was Monday, the initiation. And it says, rite of passage, you're going somewhere sacred. And again, you have these dark clouds and the lightning bolts. And if you walk through this doorway, you're walking into a new world. I mean, look at how beautiful it is. It's like a seaside paradise here with the blue water, the pink sky. So these rocks and all of this darkness and these snakes, this is what we've been living in, a lot of us, a lot of darkness. And a lot of things have come to light in 2019 when we have let people, places, and things go. And it's time for us to walk through this door. We've gone through all of the lessons that we needed to learn. And we've gained the knowledge. And if we didn't learn the lessons, they're going to keep repeating. So word to the wise, just pay attention, learn the lesson and move on. Do not keep trying to make something work that's not working. It's not working for a reason. If the door isn't opening up, it's not your door. And it says that there's a temple in India that looks terrifying from the outside, but inside it is filled with jewels and is one of the most loving places. This card represents the journey that the soul pilgrim is required to take to reach somewhere sacred, but only the initiated can enter. Perhaps that's where you are right now. You're being tested and initiated because you have headed somewhere sacred. So believe that all of these tests and all of these challenges and all of these heartbreaking, painful things that are happening, they're all tests. These are not just to torment you. It's not that, oh, always me. I just have bad luck. I don't know. Somebody must have put a black magic on me or someone has cast a spell on me to make, you know, me suffer. No, this is life. Okay. In some instances, maybe some of that could happen. But more than likely, a lot of people out there just keep on thinking that it's just not, you know, fair, that life isn't fair. And that is true. It is not fair. But without these tests, we cannot progress. So be thankful for the tests and the lessons because this is pushing you forward. It's pushing you out of this darkness into that sacred place. Okay. I mean, you're going to shift from, you know, the darkness into the light. Okay, and if you're in the middle of an initiation right now and you're being tested right now and things are falling apart all over, you'll get through it. And one day soon, you're going to bless that thing or that person that broke you down and cracked you open. You're going to bless it and you're going to see the reason behind it because right now it's so hard sometimes to see the blessing in something. Like, how could this be a blessing? But further down the road, to see if maybe you continued with a certain person, something bad could have happened. Okay, you're going to look back and you're going to realize it was all worth it. So do not fear what you're going through right now. We're all going through it, myself included. Believe me, I've gone through things this past year that have literally brought me to my breaking point in my knees. I thought I'd seen it all, but no, there was a major test and it's still going on. And then the third card is trust your path. And I love the pastels of these cards. And it's just so beautiful. Like it's so refreshing to look at like a bright picture like this. You could just feel the peacefulness and the softness just emanating from it. And it says, if you knew you would be supported, what would you do? You know, it's, you know, saying to trust your path. I mean, it's no one else's decision but yours what path you follow. And no one has the right to tell you, well, you can't do this, or you can't do that. We're all on our spiritual path. We're at different levels. We're at different parts of it. Some are further ahead. Some are just beginning to wake up. But, you know, this is a card telling you to trust whatever you're doing and whatever you're being pulled towards. Okay, is what's meant for you to do. Okay, and no one could decide that for you. The universe is conspiring. Keep facing your true north. Your job is not to pave the path, but to simply keep facing your true north and take one step after another. If you do this, you can't go wrong. Don't waver or doubt. Use your heart as a compass and put one foot in front of the other. If you follow the invisible trail of what lights you up, you will light up the world without even trying. Exactly. When you follow your bliss, it will just shine from you. It will shine out from you, and it will be felt by other people. I mean, people are very smart. They can tell if someone's being fake and just going through the motions because they want to copy someone else. But when you truly follow what's calling to you and what your inner bliss is, people know. People know that you're being authentic. And most people don't follow the highest call of their soul because they're waiting to see the end destination before they take the first step. They want to know what's in the future. And we never know what's in the future. And what holds people back from taking the step is fear. Okay? People fear the unknown. And, you know, I mean, I can't blame them. I used to be one of those people before I decided to just, you know, take a step forward and just follow my own, you know, feelings and follow where I think I need to go and what I need to do. And I just do it day by day. I don't think that far ahead because it could produce a lot of anxiety because we don't know what the future holds. Okay, so just keep moving and open yourself up to a whole new level of support. You know, and things are not going to work out the way you planned. Oh, believe me, my life isn't working out the way I planned. There's some major shift that took place. But just have faith and keep showing up. And things are going to work out better than you could even imagine. Okay? Trust your path and just let your soul lead you to what you're meant to do. And just steps each day, even baby steps, like I always say, will end up, you know, amounting to something at the end of the week, the end of the month, the end of the year. And don't listen to anyone if they try to discourage you that, oh, you can't do that or you shouldn't do that. Forget it. I personally, in my real world, as opposed to my online world, I don't have any friends that are into, you know, tarot and crystals and things like that. So I kind of felt like when I started doing that, I was on my own and independent, but I'm a very independent person to begin with. I've always been a loner and I've always done my own thing. So to me, it wasn't too hard, you know, doing what I wanted, even though the crowd wasn't going to go along with it. And most people don't even know that I read tarot and I'm into all kinds of spiritual things. And that doesn't matter. It's what I want to do with my life because it's mine to live. And so is yours. It's your decision. But there's a whole bunch of people in the spiritual community, some good, some bad. I've had to weed through a lot of people that were very negative. They would say love and light to your face, and then behind your back, they'd be gossiping and doing things to undermine you. So be aware of that, but follow your bliss is what I'm trying to say. Trust your path and trust what you're feeling, your intuition, what you're meant to do. If it's to change your career, if it's to start taking up spiritual studies, if it's to make videos, to become a healer, whatever it is, it's going to keep coming back to you until you finally pay attention to that nudge you're getting from the universe. What a beautiful reading today. If you've enjoyed this reading, please like it by giving it a thumbs up, share it, and above all, subscribe because I will be back with more.